Podcasts are increasing in popularity. And it's not surprising, because for content creators, they are a great way to engage with their audience. So today it's all about podcasting and RME audio interfaces. But before we continue, please make sure that you hit that like and subscribe button and that you also click on the notifications bell to enhance your RME experience by getting all the future updates from this channel. So why RME? Well, think of an RME audio interface as an all-in-one solution for mixing and recording. And the Babyface Pro is no exception. Normally for podcast recordings, you would use something like this, a big, heavy mixing board. But let's be honest, most of the time you only need two channels and something that you can put in your bag. The Babyface Pro is not only bus powered, it gives you two high quality channels of microphone preamplification. And on top of that, it works for macOS, Windows PC, and also iOS devices.
Let's head over to TotalMix FX, which is our free mixing software that comes standard with all RME audio interfaces. TotalMix FX can replace most of the mixing desks out there, and it's a complete mixing solution. As you can see, we have three rows at our disposal. On the top, I have my two microphones. On the second row, I have the so-called software playback channels. These are the channels that you can assign in your DAW or in your music software. So my first channel is my Skype, the second channel is iTunes, and the third channel is called Effects. In this case, I have this assigned to my Ableton session with some effects loops and some drum loops. And on the bottom, we have the physical outputs, the headphones of the Babyface Pro and the mains, which stands for the XLR outputs on the back of the Babyface Pro. What's so great now about TotalMix FX is that we have for every input and output channel a dedicated EQ. Right now, I'm recording myself with the Audio-Technica BP40, which is a nice dynamic microphone. But for my voice, it's a little bit too dark. So now I'm deactivating the EQ, and as you can hear, it's a little bit darker and not so pronounced for my voice. So I'm switching back to the EQ, and we have a clear and nice sound for podcasts and radio sessions.
Thanks for watching this video. This was only a short introduction for a new video series about content creation with RME audio interfaces. If you have ideas or questions, please write them down in the comment section below. See you next time.